I'm Anna Salomons. I'm a labor economist studying the labor market effects of automation, and I work at Utrecht University in the Netherlands.
My name is David Otter. I'm the Ford professor and associate head of the MIT Department of Economics. I'm a labor economist. I work on questions of automation, globalization, demand for skills, earnings, and inequality.
So our new paper, together with David Otter, we're studying the labor market effects of automation, looking both at jobs and at what's happening to the labor share, so the share that labor takes in total income. And we find that the job impact is neutral to positive, but that labor share of total income is actually declining as a result of automation.
No, the robots will not take all of our jobs. I think the focus on jobs is actually the wrong focus. The concern should not be about the number of jobs, but whether those are jobs that can support a reasonable standard of living and what set of people have access to them. We have more great jobs in the world than we've ever had in terms of the number of creative, rich, rewarding, and well-remunerated jobs. But we also have a lot of low-skill jobs, jobs in personal services, food service, cleaning, security, home health aides, that are not well-paid, are not stable, and don't offer a very good standard of living. And that latter category is growing really rapidly. So you could say, on the one hand, great, we have a lot of jobs. On the other hand, those are not the jobs we'd most like to have. And so I think the concern ought to be about what is the comparative advantage of human labor in an increasingly automated world.
So education and healthcare are special in the sense that we don't find a strong decline in the labor share there, and that's likely or possibly the case because the technologies that are used there are mostly complementing labor, so they're not really yet able to automate the direct things that workers are doing in those industries.
So if I were a parent, which I am, and if I gave advice, and let's say just for hypothetically my kids listen to me, I would recommend that they choose a career that encapsulates two things. One, it draws on a body of expertise, something that requires judgment and creativity. So that could be medicine, that could be law, that could be design, could be managing other people. The other is I recommend they do something that complements that body of technical expertise with expertise in human interactions, with communicating with others, with leading others, with motivating, talking, persuading. That kind of piece of the pie where technical skills meets interpersonal expertise is the area where human judgment is most scarce, most important, and most difficult to substitute. Technology is not solely to blame for the many divides in American society. There are many societies that have similar technology that are not as divided as ours is, but technology has certainly contributed and exacerbated some of those divides. And then, of course, our institutions also affect how those economic forces feed through into social outcomes. There are many countries that have a more comprehensive safety net, a better retraining system, and a greater sense of shared responsibility. And so the kind of ragged edge of capitalism has not been quite as ragged in other advanced economies. We need to be much more effective at getting adults into skills programs and retrained. That could be through our community college system and also through apprenticeships, through extension programs. The U.S. has a very decentralized and kind of underfunded training system infrastructure in this area. Tariffs on steel and aluminum will raise employment in the aluminum and steel industry in the United States. They have to. They will almost surely. If we can't substitute those imports, there's enormous demand for those inputs. More of that will be produced in the United States. It may reduce employment in U.S. industry altogether because it's going to raise the price of inputs to autos, to heavy equipment, to many, many things that use steel and aluminum, even to soda cans. That could have a dampening effect. So it's possible that the overall effect on employment would be negative. I don't think this is going to be a net job creator. It's certainly not going to raise GDP. It will be redistributive. I don't think you can make the argument that this will just make us better off, that we can just tariff our way into prosperity. You could make the argument, I think it's reasonable, I might not support it, but it's a reasonable argument to say that this is part of a long game and this is one of the first pawns in that game, and maybe strategically over the long run, that could be beneficial if played strategically and effectively.